Hello everyone, today we're going to start with a topic called machine learning, which is just in continuity of our core lesson, that is artificial intelligence. And whenever we're going to deal with artificial intelligence or AI, we have to take care and we have to give basic glimpses of machine learning, because this is one of the major component of artificial intelligence. Now whenever we're going to deal with the artificial intelligence, so far the machine learning and the other components are concerned, deep learning and machine learning, these two things should be taken care about, because these are going to help the machines to identify certain models based on the perceptions and whatever facts we have already identified earlier, and what type of output you have already got. Based on the input and output you have got, certain logics or algorithms are supposed to be created by itself. Whenever these things are being successfully done, or it is being analytically being considered properly by the machines, we can find it out. The machine has learned something. So algorithms are there. In certain cases, the perception of final analytical model based on which the machine can understand the logic based on the previous logics, we can say the things have been done or the machine has learned something. So today's topic is machine learning. So let's start with certain basic glimpses of it. Now, whenever we're going to go for it, it is basically a field of study that gives the computer the capability to learn without being explicitly programmed. That means for each and everything, we are not going to program certain things, but based on the previous input and whatever output you have got, so recognition of patterns should be done. And whenever you are making a system learn the patterns based on which they can provide or restructure certain models or pattern, we can find it out, the machine learning process is successful. Now, whenever you go for this, certain things have to be taken care about, or it may be hierarchical part. And in that hierarchy, you can find it out, the artificial intelligence is the outer core, which includes each and every set. Within it, there is a subset called machine learning. Whenever you are just going to put the basic input, the data, and the whatever output you have got, whatever experience you had, these things are there. Within it, you can find it out, the neural network, the general process of the passing on the simulations through the neuron. That concept has been considered or imbibed in the neural network technology, and within it you can find it out, the deep learning. So whenever you go for the artificial intelligence, one of the very component or main component, machine learning, within it you can find it out, the neural network and deep learning. Now let's start with the machine learning. And whenever you're going to start the machine learning, the components or the way it is being actually doing, just to have the proper analytical basis of providing or restructuring a model, so that a machine can automatically identify a structure and the model can be built based on the previous pattern recognition. So you are going to have certain things, and those certain things are nothing but learn from data. That is, the identify the patterns, make decisions with minimal human interventions. That means for each and every thing, we cannot program explicitly a machine. Just it is going to take care of its previous experience or the first history, and based on which it can provide or restructure the logics and the models. So algorithms are to be built or restructured or programmed by itself based on the previous algorithms. Now, whenever you go for it, certain things have been taken care about. And in that case, what are we going to do? They let the computer program for themselves. And in case of traditional programming, whatever you do, now we simply provide the data and program. That means the logics or algorithm, and we are going to get the output. But in machine learning, you are not going to provide the program, because you want the machine to learn how to get a particular output from the given set of input based on certain logic which is being kept in a black box. That black box logic is to be delivered and structured when modeled by a machine. This is called machine learning. You know what type of output you are supposed to be getting. You know the labeled data, unlabeled data, or mixed type of data. And based on which you have to find it out which perceptions or which type of patterns you have to apply so that these given set of input can provide the expected output. So this is the machine learning part, which is going to be included. And then for this, whatever you have to say, now you just have to find it out, the what are the different types of machine learning that can be applicable in the modern days. And in the cases, there are supervised learning, unsupervised learning, semi-supervised learning, and reinforcement learning. Now these components will be dealt later on through our next lesson. But give a simple glimpse, in supervised learning, we are just going to have the categorized data input so that you can look up at it. Okay, these are the label data on which the things or logic should be applied. In unsupervised data, the data are not labeled. It is just supposed to do the survey randomly, and in that case, the pattern selections or the pattern recognition should be directly to be done, and it is to be left with the machines. It is not the guided one. And in semi-supervised learning, the labeled and unlabeled data, that means something is being identified and categorically we are going to hint the system to please look into this code data, and something you have to find it out yourself. That means the system is being given the opportunity to identify certain data from a group, and we are going to help him also or help it also with certain group of data. That means something is labeled data, system know this data I have to look after, and certain data they are on which or in which the system is supposed to get the another lot of data. Then the reinforcement learning, certain awards process is being there, some considerations are to be there in another level in a complex mathematical procedure. So we're just going to deal with this core component in the lessons it is going to come, and then going to have a simple little glimpses. And today we're just going to give you the applications of machine learning, and in that case you can find it out rainfall predictions, handwriting recognitions, face recognitions. Then the vector machines is there, decision trees there, credit card fraud is there, NLP analysis is there, image compressions, deep learning, targeted advertising using machine learning, streaming on Netflix and Amazon Web Services. Now we can find it for all the cloud-based models are basically being guided by the artificial intelligence, and in that case, machine learning is going to help to find it out the what type of patterns are being followed by the customers for viewing the online web series or something like that, or the services they are expecting from the web or online services. Because in Ravi days, whatever you are just going to find it out on your threshold, you can find it out, these are being supported by artificial intelligence. That means the pattern of purchase buy in the normal market economy, the demand supply is there. So demand is to be something, it is being guided also that a person is supposed to buy three things. Please insist or please imbibe the concept of purchasing five things instead of three things, because you can find it out that pattern of purchase or is something like that which can be identified, then you can provide lots of information regarding that pattern to that customer. So normally these things are being happening. So there are lots of things which are going to include in our daily life without knowing that these are actually being guided by artificial intelligence, and better to say through the machine learning, the machine is going to guide you that this type of things you are having in your periphery, you can also check for it. So let's find it out. I think at the very basic level, it's enough for it so that you can identify, you can include, or you can start a thought process on going through the machine learning. And in that case, I'm going to give you a simple assignment that can you trust the users of ML in Tesla? Now, I think the Elon Musk company Tesla is including and imbibing certain major things of artificial intelligence in their Tesla company in various products. You just have to identify that how does the Tesla company is imbibing or embedding machine learning in their product and services. So thank you. Have a good day. Stay fit, stay healthy. And please be ready for the next component in the continuity of the series of artificial intelligence. We are going to deal with certain other components of machine learning as well as the deep learning. Thank you.